have a lot of time to spend in Egypt. Here
we go. National! Huh!
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan. Thank you.
don't we recall?
The day the tradition of closing ties between the United States as nations built by immigrants both enjoy many ties to the old world. We both have growing links with the nation relationship. We are still each other's largest trading partner. The commercial interaction of our people generally flee from writing and expanding upon our many bonds of enterprise and commerce. It has also a matter of breaking metals. Environmental issues, especially those dealing with air pollution, are serious challenges. Today, we must build on what has already been accomplished in recent and cooperating to make this a more prosperous world, and also to make this a safer and peaceful world, and save a deceived mankind from tyranny. And the United States, Canada, and the United States have shared
the end of the next century. If all its members carry their fair share, NATO will be able to preserve the peace, which is, after all, its primary mission.
That Canada is taking to combat the ugly threat of terrorism. The free and democratic nations of the world are just now mobilizing to rid mankind of this plague. There's every reason for optimism that this fight will be won, and that international terror, the people of our two countries, are setting an example to the rest of the world. We're proving that two proud and independent nations can live side by side, each respecting the sovereignty and the rights of the other. Our court is welcome. Aronza Java.
Thank you, Mr. President, Monsieur President. It's good to be with you again. As you'll recall, you were the first head of government I met with, and this was the first capital I visited only days after the installation of our government, 18 months ago, yesterday. Some days in the House of Commons, Dan and I want to repeat now that harmonious and fruitful relations between Canada and the United States are a top priority with us. With that in mind, we agreed from the beginning that it would be useful, indeed indispensable, for us to meet annually. So we met 1 year ago in Quebec City. You remember, Mr. President, it was a cold day. You wore a green tie. And Tip wasn't there. And we launched a new action, de cordialité et d'égards mutuels entre les deux peuples qui se tiennent en haute estime. Canadians and Americans, though different in many ways, share many of the same values.
But let me say first, Mr. President and Nancy, that I come here today with Mila to celebrate the common heritage, the community. We are more than one another's best friends. We are far and away one another's largest trading partner. But we don't take one for the granted.
Le président Reagan et moi-même entretenons des contacts très étroits, et nous nous efforçons résolument de faire en sorte que l'association commerciale entre nos deux nations continue de croître, nourrie par des intérêts communs et une confiance mutuelle.
Tell the photographers to come through.
Okay.
Over here?
Yeah.
I tried to tell the one that you told me about the bond, about the cardinal, the turn of.
Excuse me, I just want to let you know they cut it down to three waves. First wave will be American still photographers, second wave will be Canadian press, and the third wave will be American TV and writers and correspondents.
All right, we're trying to ask questions. That was the one about the fellow who said that he was dancing. Asked him to dance.
Oh,
the guy that drunk.
Oh,
I forgot the punchline.
Right.
When I was that was it. There's where I went wrong.
Some people from Southern California disagree.
Mr. Prime Minister, why is Canada giving aid to Nicaragua?
I beg your pardon?
Is Canada not providing foreign aid to Nicaragua? Why?
Canada provides foreign aid to dozens and dozens and dozens of countries around the world. One of our noblest traditions is the, as is yours, is the providing of aid to countries less well off than ourselves. We've been doing it ever since Canada was founded pretty well. And it's a noble tradition that we plan to maintain.
How do you feel about that, Mr. President?
That's
a matter
for Southern State candidate.
Lights, please.
This way, please.
Thank you.
Good to see you again. My pleasure. How are you, Jen?
Marvin, very good.
Every time we come from White House, I've seen you. That's everywhere else. Good to see you.
You're Mr. President.
Yeah, no, that was a. They asked me about that this morning. And I just refused.
Thank you.
Thanks, President. How are you?
It's all taken up there.
Stop telling jokes. Oops, sorry.
Well, Mr. President, and colleagues,